Hi, I'm Jordan Rubin. Welcome to Ancient Medicine Today, brought to you by DrAxe.com. We're going to talk about a topic that is absolutely newsworthy. It's groundbreaking. It's so important. It's slow cookers. The good, the bad, and the ugly. Everything you ever heard about slow cooking, throw it out the window because we're going to get to the truth right here on Ancient Medicine Today. Sorry, I'm joking and making light of slow cooking, but truth be told, slow cooking, crock potting, if you will, has been used for thousands of years, and it really is a great way to get absolute nutritional extraction from your foods. Saves time, saves effort, and we're going to talk to you about the benefits of slow cooking and some of the things you should avoid. Number one, if you slow cook, you have to be careful with what equipment or utensils you use, because ceramic can contain low levels of naturally occurring lead. Naturally occurring lead is not bad for everyone, but we oftentimes are exposed to this toxic metal in large amounts. So when you are looking at slow cooking, the worn ceramic can induce leaching of lead. So you want to call manufacturers of your ceramic slow cooker, crock pot, etc., and ask them if they've tested for lead. I recommend clay and stainless steel crock pots instead because they will not increase your lead exposure. Number two, when you use certain grains, seeds, and legumes, you want to be careful about phytic acids. Grains, beans, and legumes have phytic acid, which is an anti-nutrient compound that can block nutrient absorption. What do you want to do? Soak and sprout beans, legumes, grains, and seeds before using in your slow cooker or a crock pot, or just buy sprouted grains and seeds and beans, which are becoming much more available. The pressure cooking already helps break down phytates, but the sprouting pushes it over the edge, the healthy edge, that is. BPA. So if you buy slow-cooked products in cans or store them in cans, you want to be careful and make sure they're BPA-free, because BPA, bisphenol A, is linked to infertility, weight gain, prediabetes, irregular heartbeat, and even cancers. All right, what are the benefits of slow cooking? I like everything fast, but I'm learning how to slow down when I cook because slow cooking saves time. It reduces the risk of ordering takeout. So it allows you to have food quickly after it's been cooked slowly, meaning there's a lot of leftovers and you eat it all in one bowl, kind of like a soup, a stew, etc. So it eliminates the risk of takeout. Never even thought of that. Slow cooking tenderizes meats, makes it easier to chew, and you use less electricity than an oven. And slow cooking harmonizes nutrients and brings out flavor. See, this is such powerful information. If you have slow cooking friends, if you know a bunch of crock pots, I recommend that you click the share button right now, because this information is absolutely important. I know I'm making light of it, but Dr. Axe is a huge slow cooker. He loves it. One pot meals, slow cooking. I'm sort of learning to appreciate it myself, even during this broadcast. Here's a great crock pot breakfast casserole recipe. I'm not going to go through all of it, but man, it makes me hungry. It's got some organic goat and sheep milk cheese. It's got eggs, kefir, really, really delicious. And by the way, if you love recipes, why don't you head over to our Facebook page, then go to DrAxe.com and subscribe, because we've got hundreds of recipes. And make sure you're subscribed to this YouTube channel, because we just love food. We love recipes, and yes, we love slow cooking. Slow down, cook healthy, and you will love this particular recipe. Here's a slow cooker French onion soup. My wife loves French onion soup, and it's hard to make at home to have it taste really good. This is a way to do it with really healthy ingredients. Check that out. You got herbs, you got spices, you got butter, you got ACV, beef broth, really, really delicious. Carne asada tacos. If you want to use steak and tacos or fajitas, you know how it's sort of hard to chew? Well, this will change that, because slow cooking tenderizes meat, as we learned, and it reduces the risk of takeout. Remember that one? That's huge. Okay, then we got, this is yummy, slow cooker pumpkin butter recipe. I don't eat enough pumpkin. Pumpkin is relegated to Thanksgiving and a little bit at Christmas, but you know pumpkin is loaded with vitamin A, beta carotene, loaded with fiber, and other minerals. This is so delicious. You can this pumpkin butter and store it quite a bit of time in the refrigerator. This is delicious, and it's loaded with healthy herbs and spices. Slow cooker pumpkin butter, I want to make it right now. Ancient Medicine Today, we're talking about slow cooking, the good, the bad, and the ugly. The dangers are lead exposure, phytic acid, and BPA if you use the wrong type of utensils, and if you purchase previously slow cooked foods in lead or let's just say the wrong type of metal can. However, there's all these dangers to slow cooking, but there's all these delicious benefits and great recipes you can make. I want to end on a good note with our slow cooker pumpkin butter recipe. Folks, I know that you love recipes, you love eating, and depending on what time of year you're watching, you could already have a pumpkin ready to be put into a slow cooker. Bottom line, folks, if you're someone who's busy, if you want to improve digestion, if you want to follow the wisdom of the ancients, get out that crock pot or slow cooker, make sure it is not made of ceramic that's also been scratched, and then go on and start slow cooking. You'll be glad you did. I'm Jordan Rubin, here for Ancient Medicine Today. Have a healthy, slow-cooked day.
Hi, Dr. Axe here. I want to say thanks so much for checking out this YouTube video, and also don't forget to subscribe if you want to get more great content on things like herbs, essential oils, natural remedies, and how to use food as medicine. Also, check out more of our content on my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.